Good morning, everyone. In our previous class, we have completed regarding the list. So let us have a recap. The last thing we discussed about a list was how you use the join method, wherein it takes a list of strings and concatenates the elements. So this is how we had taken a list of words, delimiter was space, and then you use the join method on the delimiter, using which it joined those words. When it came to objects and values, we saw that in Python this was referencing to the same object. When it came to aliasing, we saw that how you can give two different names to the same list. So here, when you say b equal to a, you are giving an alias name to this a object, which is also known as reference. When it comes to using list as function arguments, this is what we did. So here we discussed about call by value and call by reference. So with this, we ended the chapter on list. Today we will be going ahead with files. So this is the remaining chapter from your module 2. Let us have a discussion on this. What are files? A file is some information or data which stays in the computer storage device. So till now we have been seeing how we write a program, but if in case you want to store it onto your secondary memory, what we make use of is files. The different kinds of files are music files, video files, text files, multimedia files, etc. Generally, you categorize them as text file and binary file, where text files are simple text, whereas binary files contain binary data which is only readable by computer. Just now we had a discussion saying that files are on your secondary memory. They reside here. That's how you can store them permanently. This is the hardware architecture that we have already seen in our introductory chapter. When this, you assume this to be your secondary memory, all your files are stored here. So whenever you want to access it, you need something known as a file handle. Why we need this? In order to perform those basic CRUD operations. Now what we mean by CRUD operations? It's basically create, read, update and delete, which in other terms can be called as, if you want to open, close a file, read a file or write to it, you need a handle so that you can access this file which is on the secondary memory. So what is that file handle? How do you create it? How do you use it? Let us see further. What are the different file operations that we can do? Open a file, close, read, write, tell the current position in the file, seek the required position to a file. These are the six different operations that we can do on a file. So, in order to open a file, first you need to create it. Only when it exists, you can open it. If it does not exist, you can't open a file. So, what is the first thing you do? You create a file by the name .txt and type a few lines as shown in the image below. So, create any file with some name, but extension should be .txt. Write a few lines into that file and save it. This is how you are creating a text file. Then create a file with .py extension, say for example f1.py, as follows, and run it. So what I have done in this .py file, I am just using a file handle. Now this f1 that I am using here, that is your file handle. Any variable can be given as file handle. So I have given f1. So what are you trying to do here? f1 equal to, open is the function that you would be using to open a file. What file you want to open? bio.txt. And then I am just printing this file handle, whatever data it shows us. So if you see the output of this simple file, in order to observe this, your text file should be ready. So what we have done here, when you print f1, you see that the file handle prints the information that the file that you're trying to open is bio.txt. The mode in which you're opening is the read mode. You know that the different modes of opening a file are, either you open it read in mode, write mode, or the append mode. So we'll be discussing in detail regarding these modes. So one simple file where you have created the file handle. Only using this you can perform the further operations. So this is what we mean by a file handle. So opening a file, we have used the open function. Two arguments are required. One is the name of the file and another is which mode we should open it. If you see this earlier example, we have not specified the mode in which we are opening it. So by default it happens to be the read mode. So the modes are here, read, open, in read only you can read the file, but you cannot edit or delete anything inside. Write mode, you can open with write power, means if the file exists, then delete all content and open it to write. One thing to note about the write mode is, if the file doesn't exist, it creates it. But if in an existing file you want to write it, it overwrites it, that is deletes all the existing data and then writes the content. But if you don't want to delete the existing data, then you need to use the append mode, open in append mode, so that it takes, starts writing to the end of the file wherever your earlier content has stopped. The default mode is read-only, that is if you do not wish any mode, it will open the file as ready. Let us open a file. Just now we have created a file. Let us open in the read mode. File not found error. When do we get this? If you happen to specify a file name which does not exist, then you get a file not found error. It tells you no such file or directory. Here I made a simple change. I just removed the home. The name of my file was bio.txt. But when I give bio.txt, there is no such file which is existing. So it gave you a file not found error. Whenever you open a file, you should make sure that you close it using the method close, that is f1.close. So f1, we are again referring to the file handle. On that, you are calling the close method. Any operations that you are performing on the file should be done using the file handle that you have created. So earlier slide also you have seen, we have done f1.open, right? So f1.close. Always make sure you explicitly close each open file once its job is done and you have no reason to keep it open, because there is an upper limit to the number of files a program can open. If you exceed that limit, there is no reliable way of recovery, so the program could crash. So always it's a good habit to close the file whichever you have opened. The third operation is reading a file. So if you look at this, now you have created a file handle. So all these statements we are writing in the .py file. In the .txt file, we have just written a few lines for reference. But your coding part will always be done in the file called .py. So here you are creating a file handle and opening the file which you want to read. You are printing what is there in the file handle. So this is the line that gets printed here. Next, you are printing f1.read. That is, whatever is being read, you are printing that on the screen. So using the file handle, in order to read a file, you need to use the read method. And then close the file after you have read it. So when you do a f1.read, it has read the contents of your file, what were there in bio.txt. Now when it comes to reading a file, there are three ways you can do it. One is read, read line, and read lines. So just now we have seen how read works. Now when you want to read line by line from a file, that is one line at a time, that is when you are making use of read line method. So if you can see here, you have created the file handle again, opened the text file, printed the file handle. Next, you are printing f1.readline. So when you are saying read line, it prints you one line at a time. So if you want to see all the lines, you can put this in a for loop and then it prints one each line one by one. But when you use only read, it prints you the entire contents of the file and then you are closing it. Now, when you want all the contents of your file in the form of a list, the next method you would be using is, so if you look at this, to read all the lines in the list, we use the read lines method. So this S is extra here. So what you're trying to do here, open, create a file handle, print the file handle which is printing this line, and then you're doing a f1.readlines. So if you see now, a list is being created. So this list got created here, and then you close the file, right? You can even loop through the lines in a file object. So how do you do that? F1 equal to open, for x in F1, print x and equal to. So just now we had seen, for everything you need to create the file handle. This is the iteration variable for your file 1, that is the handle. So whatever is there in that, it prints one by one and then the separator, and you're using this a space, right? So if you look at this, this is what is happening. So a space is being created for that reason. Now, having seen the basics, what is a file, what are the different operations you can perform on a file, till now I discussed only the three operations, which is how you open a file, how you read a file, and then how you create a file, right? In order to perform any operation, creating the file becomes very important. So if you look at this program to read a file whose name is entered, to do this, you are accepting the name from the user, name equal to input, enter the file name. Then file object equal to open, you are passing this name. Earlier what you used to do, file handle equal to open file name. So this file name we have accepted from the user, so that you are passing it as an argument to open. Then print file handle dot read. Okay, so you are just reading the file, and we know that we have not given any mode, so by default it is opening in the read mode only. And then file object dot close, we are explicitly closing the file. So if we go through again, for today's class we have been discussing how you open a file, right? So we started with how you create a file. These are the different operations, among which I have discussed only the first three for this particular class. So if you look at it, create a file, first we are creating one text file. If this does not exist, you will get an error when you try to open it. So I have created it, then you are in a file.py where you have written the statements. When you print the handle, this is what it is giving you, the name of the file and the mode in which you have opened it. Arguments to open function, whenever you want to open it, the file path and the mode in which it should open. These are the different modes in which you can open. Do remember, whenever you are opening it in write mode, it will open a new file if it doesn't exist. But if you open in an existing file the write mode, it deletes the previous content. So you need to be careful whenever you are opening the file in write mode. Opening in append mode allows you to add it to the end of the existing file, and the default mode is read mode. File not found error. If you have not given the correct name or the file doesn't exist, you get a file not found error. Closing a file, the method used is f1.close. Then when it comes to reading a file, three ways. One is the dot read, dot read line, and third is the dot read lines. When you say read, it is showing you the entire contents of the file. When you say read line, it shows you one line at a time. When you say read lines, it puts it in the form of a list. So we have seen how you can even loop through the object, and one simple program on how you can open a file that is whose name is entered by the user, right? So file is an important concept because majorly you'll be dealing with file handling, how you work with it. So this is the basics of the three operations that we can perform. The further operations, how to write to a file, how you seek the position, or how you take the cursor position to a particular line, we shall discuss in a next class. That's all for today. Thank you.